Hello and welcome. And then I am planning to show you that how we can replace this Toyota 2.2 liters gasoline engine. Okay, and then I take this battery away, and for that battery remove you need this 10 millimeter wrench, and there is this two areas. There I open these bolts. Let's go to look closer. There is this battery, and I open these two cables in here, and 10 millimeter is my wrench size. Okay. I leave this battery away. Good. Okay, and next step is to take this radiator away. And before of that, I need to take those coolant away. And that's I need canister, what I insert in here below of this car engine. There, and then we go to look. First is my canister, and then I need to open this fine out bolt, and it is this white one in here. In that one I open that bolt, and now coolant is draining out. There, coolant is draining out, and then I open that cap. This coolant start to dry much faster. Okay, and then I need to wait so long that all coolant are away, and then I can continue. Okay, and then when I continue this radiator take away, I need to take out this hose, and for that job I need tongs that I can compress this part in this clamp, and same time I can move that in here, and then I can use my hand and I can carefully take the hose away in that way. And then there's second small hose in here, but I take in same way away in here. Cool. Okay, and then next task is to take out these metallic support plates, and for that job I need wrench, longer bar, and 12 millimeter socket. 12. And it fits in here. Just perfectly. Two bolts. What I need to take out. They are in here. And there is this metallic. The support thing, and in here, similar. Okay, cool. And now this radiator moves nicely, and then I can take in same way these radiators, these electric connectors. What are in here, like in that one, and when I press that part, at same time I lift, I can take this out, and then there's second, similar in here, in this one, and there's idea also that I press that, and then I take this away in that way. There's pressing inside and then pull out. There is this pressing point. Okay, good. So now this radiator is moving, and then I need to take second clamp out, and this clamp position is in here a little bit down. This in that, and the loop in there. There is this my next target, and that one I can take away. So, but I take my tongs. Tongs are here, and then I little bit. I take this clamp. Okay, away in here, and then I move my hands. I rotate a little bit that. This. Okay, now there's coming coolant. I need to wait a little bit, because otherwise coolant goes in this ground, and I wait so long that this my coolant canister in here is full. Okay. Okay, and then when I am planning to take this radiator out, I have to take out this automatic transmission coolant hoses, what are just in here, these parts. And for that job, I need tongs that I can compress that clamp in that way, and then I can move that clamp in this down area in this way, and then I move that clamp in here. Okay, now this is first step is made, and then second step is that I take screwdriver and I insert that screwdriver in here, and I carefully start to do this. I am pressing that hose in down all areas, and then I use my hand, and now it opens. Excellent. Now I believe that this radiator is ready for lifting, and I insert my hands in here, and let's look how it moves. It actually moves very nicely. And then remember to handle this radiator really carefully, because this is very sensitive part, and there is also this radiator sensor location, even temp location, temp sensor in there, and there is this radiator grind out bolt in here, what I open. Okay, now radiator is free. Okay, and then I take also this radiator coolant hose away, and I need tongs, and I compress in here, and I move that one in here, and then I little bit rotate that, and now this hose is free. Okay, and then next step is to take this Fasher fluid tank away, and again we need this 10 millimeter socket, and there is bolt open. There is this bolt, and it looks like that, and also in here we have second bolt, and I open also that bolt. Okay, good. And now those bolts are free, and I can a little bit move that. And now when we look that, then look in the down area, and there's this this motor in here. Turbo can see this motor in that area. And next, I need to take that electric cable out in that one, and then I press that. Maybe I can take this out. Okay, and I press in here down and then pull out. Now opens, and then there's also second cable also in here, and I press also the second one. Okay, now I manage to open also that second one, so that I press that area in here, and then this first one area I press in here that way. Okay, and now this canister is almost, then there's this hose, of course. Let's go to look those hoses. There's this hose in here. This one I can open so that I move that one. Here, and I, this is first one, and then there's second here down, and there is two motor. This is for headlight, and that one is for windshield. Now I try to take them. This is quite tight. Okay, and it opens in that hose. Good. Now I believe that this Fassler fluid tank is free. Okay, and coolant is going out. Okay, and this job is ready.